Welcome back, students, to one more session of your physical chemistry chapter done. So we have almost completed your part 2 book. I gradually completed the solutions chapter. Every corner of the textbook, as I said, I keep saying the same again and again. I try to do all the combinations of numericals, because more than that, you will not be questioned. This is my request. You go through the videos, keep noting all the numericals. I've gone from the minimum level of reasoning questions or minimum level of numericals to the maximum level of numericals. That is for your grade 12. So if you practice that, I'm again specifying, it's more than enough for your board exams. Yes, then let us come back to your new chapter. We've also completed the board paper successfully. So let's come back and start with the new chapter, that is coordination chemistry. So the weightage for this chapter, coordination compounds of coordination chemistry, is 5. You'll have 3 marks questions as well as 2 marks questions. So in your 3 marks questions, you'll be given 1, 2, 3. Like, it will be again subdivided into 1, it will be subdivided into 2 and subdivided into 3. Right? 1, 9 answers. And 2 marks, again, you make it nomenclature. So in this particular thing, in 3 marks of that particular 3 questions, either they may ask you what is the type of isomerism, which I'll be doing detailedly. They may ask you why is this magnetic in nature, why is that colorless in nature, or they may ask you what is the magnetic property. Yeah, they may also ask you what are metal carbonyls in that way. So I'll be discussing everything. So the weightage of the marks is 5. So let us see the index as I do it before I start the chapter. Let us not be in a hurry. Everything will be over clearly and perfectly. So your coordination chemistry and the remaining chapters which I have, everything systematically will be done, so that you will not even, it is not required for you to refer n number of books. That particular video, note it, study it and write your exams. So let's start with the index of coordination compounds. Let's see. So in coordination compounds, I'm going to teach you about the differences between complex ion or and double salt. Okay, so basically this is the first important question which you have to study: complex compound or complex ion and double salt, that difference. We'll also be learning the definition of coordination compounds, just for introduction. So after learning, this is very important question, as I say, after learning the different terminologies which you should learn in the chapter. So I'll be teaching you so many terminologies. So any question may be asked from any part of the topic. Yes, so I'll be teaching you about complex ion, central metal atom as ligands, denticity of ligands, classification of ligands. So I'll be teaching you what are mono, bi, poly, ambidentate, chelating ligands. I'll be teaching you what is coordination number, how to calculate coordination number. I'll also show you what is coordination sphere. Then we'll calculate coordination oxidation state. Coordination number, oxidation state, compulsory you should know in this chapter. Otherwise, you can't know, you will not be able to know the hybridization also. So I'll be teaching you how to calculate the charge on the complex ion and homoleptic and heteroleptic complexes. Okay, that also we'll do. And this is effective atomic number, that is EAN. That is Sidgwick theory, nothing that, but Sidgwick theory, we'll be doing that. After that, I'll be teaching you about Werner's theory, very important question. Werner's theory, simplest theory, but we have to know the concept of that Werner's theory. Then isomerism. In isomerism, we are going to learn about three types of isomerisms rather: structural, stereo and optical isomerisms. You also have types in that, so we'll be learning every type of that. In structural, I'll be teaching about ionization, hydrate, linkage and coordination isomerism. When it comes to stereo isomerism, I'm going to teach you about square planar stereoisomerism and octahedral. Again, in square planar, I'm going to teach you types like MA to BC. Square means 4, isn't it? So 2, 3, 4, square planar, 4 ligands. So again, MA, BCD, so 4 ligands together. In octahedral, I'm going to teach octahedral, total are 6. So I'm going to teach you with a ligand of type A4B2 and this type AA2B2. I'll be teaching. So then we'll be learning about optical isomerism. So we've already seen the stereo isomerism types. I'll be teaching you about optical isomerism, where you should know what is the concept of enantiomers and diastereomers. You'll be given a complex and you'll be asked to write the enantiomeric form of that and show the diastereomeric form of that. And here I'm also going to show you picking up tetrahedral and as well as octahedral complexes. And I'll be showing you how is EDTA, that is chelating ligands, how are they linked and how is enantiomer, to write the enantiomer of that. I'll be showing you, I'll pick up 6 ligands also. I'll show you how to show the isomer of that particular thing, enantiomer of that, diastereomer of that also. So we'll be learning that. So, and most important thing here, you have to be very careful while writing or linking the ligands. Okay, don't worry, we'll do it carefully. And next important thing, I'll be ending the chapter with the most important concept, that is VBT, valence bond theory, very important. Next, crystal field theory, that is CFT theory, where we'll be studying about tetrahedral and octahedral complexes. I'll also be teaching about metal carbonyls, so very interesting, easiest topic rather. And I'll be teaching you about the color property. We very well know transition metal elements or metal atoms, they're going to show color property only because of your smaller atomic size and DD transitions. So I'll be teaching that concept here also in relation to your coordination compounds. Then I'll be finishing off with applications. As usual, your board papers also will follow the chapter, so please note the index carefully. I'll be doing it, only aim is to make you all understand the concept. And next important thing is, though I have a busy schedule, I'm trying to upload it on every day, daily basis. So please see, it's your future. If you study, you'll get marks. Uploading is the main thing. After uploading, if you are not noting it, it's meaningless me uploading the videos every day, because our main aim is to score that 95%, isn't it? 95% in chemistry getting is awesome actually. That feeling of getting more than 95% is really good, and let's work hard. I'm working hard here. I expect the same from you all too. So only thing is, from my side, I'll be very systematic in uploading. From your side, please learn it on daily basis. So note the index and let's start with the chapter.